You, let's be honest. The term practical supercar makes about as much sense as a screen door on a submarine. A supercar is by definition an extreme being. One designed to be focused, unforgiving, and bold, but perhaps this is an outdated way of thinking. Modern supercars often toe the line between luxury car and performance car. Using tech like adaptive suspensions and configurable driving modes to transform their characters. Few are actually practical though, which is why McLaren's 570 GT caught my eye. The 570 GT is for the journey, while the hardcore UXA0 that means the GT is softer and more pragmatic than its cousins. Dialing back the intensity for a more comfortable experience. But just how much muzzling did McLaren do? Has this bulldog lost its bite? Thankfully, many of my questions were answered right away. I first met the 570 GT in downtown Portland, Oregon, and the moment it pulled up, people started moving toward it as if attracted by a magnetic field. This is a gorgeous machine. An agile yet powerful design with pronounced rear haunches, a wonderful smile, and dihedral doors that open like a raptor spreading its wings. Of all my car reviews, I've never been ogled and photographed more than in the silver McLaren. At one point, a group of five knelt in front of the car to take selfies while I waited at a red light. So clearly, the GT's utility hasn't damaged its sex appeal. Things got even better in the driver's seat. I expected a $562 horsepower carbon fiber supercar to be good. But the 570 GT left me speechless. The acceleration is absolutely ferocious. As the twin-turbo 3.8-liter V8 spits 562 horsepower and 443 pound-feet of torque to the rear wheels. McLaren says 0 to 60 comes in a